Skateboarding is more than just transportation, more than a teenage hobby, more than a sport, more than a job, more than just a rebellious phase. It's everything. It's life. Period.
So skateboarding originated in the 1940s and the 1950s when surfers needed something to do when the waves were flat. So there were reports in different countries, you know, but where we think it started was in America, when surfers, you know, the waves were flat, they didn't have anything to do. So they would literally take their surfboards and find a way to screw rollerblade wheels on the bottom of them. And, you know, they would, you know, try to mimic moves of surfing on the sidewalk, and it was called sidewalk surfing. And they did it barefoot. And then, you know, it started to just evolve into what it is today.
How?
So there were skaters like Tony Alva, Stacy Peralta, Jay Adams, who skateboarding turned from, they originally started with the surfboards and then it moved to like wooden planks on wheels. And you know, they would move around and just try to do maneuvers and attempt to learn tricks and whatnot. And then that went from skating on the sidewalks to when they found somebody's empty pool in a backyard and they would start skating in the empty pool, which was the original vert skating, which is on, you know, ramps and bowls and whatnot. And so that's how it started to evolve, because it was in pools and skateboarding. They just tried, you know, skating the bowls and learning tricks, and they would find anybody's empty backyard, you know, during the drought of the 50s and the 60s, and that's how it evolved. Oh, so around that time when, like, skaters like the Jay Adams, Tony Alva, Stacy Peralta, the evolutionists of skateboarding today, when they came around, so they started skating, and then shops that were starting to make the skateboards, they would assemble teams with riders like them. And so advertisement, you know, started to come out, television advertisement, magazines, you know, shops started to form up teams, and then, you know, competitions actually started to come around in the 60s and 70s. And then just turned into modern life skateboarding.
Name and occupation?
My name is Tristan Wilson. I am a amateur skater.
And how did you get into skateboarding? Where did you hear about it?
Oh, well, when I was about 5 years old, my uncle actually got me into it. I'd always grab his board. He had a size 8, and most kids that age would have like a little mini.
Size 8, what does that mean?
Size 8 skateboard, it's the width, 8. Most pros, they ride 8.25, which is 8.25, also known as 8 1/4. Or they also go up to 9.0, which is of course a 9, and that's for mostly vert, which is pools and everything. But anyways, I started skating, and what really got me into it was my uncle, and he kind of inspired me. He was actually really good at everything. He ended up breaking both of his legs, both of his arms skating, but I didn't really care. I don't know, I just kind of started riding his board and got better and better and progressed.
How did it affect you personally?
Me personally, I think it made me tougher, made my senses sharper, because at any moment, the board can turn, do something that you don't want, and you can end up with a broken ankle or catch it right in your groin area. But me personally, I think that it made me kind of a better person and tougher, so that when I do fall now, it's just like I get up and like, oh, just a scratch and everything.
Okay, so who are your favorite skaters?
At the moment, right now, my favorite skaters, that's the top 5. They're gonna be Joseph Ducart is for sure a favorite skater right now. But second, Sean Malto, beast. Mike Mo Capaldi, Guy Muriano, and Boris Edwards.
Okay, so talk about the struggle of trying to get sponsored at the level of competition skateboarding is right now, at your age.
Nowadays, it's like, you go to the skate park, you see 10-year-olds doing crazier stuff than you. So I think it's a lot harder to get sponsored nowadays than it usually is, because if you put in a sponsor video and you're 17, but then there's a 10-year-old or 11-year-old just as good as you, they're gonna choose 11-year-old, because they have time to progress. They have age. They'll do is just get better, better, better. But if you're 17, obviously you're older. You don't have that much time to get better, but it's a lot harder nowadays. I made a sponsored video and they told me to do bigger stuff because they had kids coming in, like 12-year-olds, doing the same stuff as me. So yes, I would love to go pro. I would not want to end up, like most people, hating their job. I want to go to work every day knowing like I'm doing something I love and I won't ever stop. I'm kind of very familiar with this because I've got kicked out of a lot of spots. I've been arrested. I've been chased by cops because they're skating a spot that I can't. They don't want to be liable for a fall, but no skater is really gonna fall on someone's property and then say, "Man, I'm gonna sue the whole company." Like, no skater does that. If they fall, they're like, "Crap! Like, I have to get back up again." They give you fat tickets, like $500 tickets, and pretty big struggle because there's not a lot of skate spots around Ontario. Like, I have to go to the skate park. Society builds them for us, but it's not what we want. We don't like all vert. Some of us like all street. There's some people that like vert. I don't think they will ever make a skate park that exactly gives everybody what they want unless they team up with the skaters around their neighborhood and talk to them and build the design around them, take pictures of spots and stairs and measure them and rebuild the exact stairs. They need to start building better stuff for the skaters so we don't vandalize their property. One moment you feel like you're on the top of the world, landing a trick is so great. Next moment you could be on the floor with a broken ankle. Skating, you just have to take that risk and you gotta love what you do and never give up on it.
Name and occupation.
Chris Townsend, I'm an amateur skateboarder in Ontario, California.
How'd you get into it?
I was going through my garage when I was like 5, and I just found this old board, and I hopped on it, and it stuck with me till now.
How did it affect you personally?
Because of skating, now I have the friends that I have, do stuff that I get to do, makes me more adventurous, you know? I didn't have skateboarding in the media right now.
So who are your favorite skaters?
Right now, Tori Pudlow, and Mike Moe, and said, do I want to get smoked? I do, but it's not gonna happen.
Are you a street skater or a vert skater?
Street. I can't skate for my life. If you love something, you stick to it.
Name and occupation?
My name is Ricky Guerra and I'm an amateur skater.
And how did you get into it?
I was grown around like the whole skateboarding scene, so I just started like getting used to the idea of just skating around my friends.
How did it affect you personally?
It gave me a whole like new perspective on life.
So who are your favorite skaters?
Dylan Reeder and Austin Gillette.
Okay, so do you want to get sponsored?
Yes.
Are you going to go pro?
Depends where I'm at in like a year or so.
So how hard is it to get sponsored at the level of competition skateboarding is at currently?
Extremely hard.
Why?
Because everybody wants to go pro and they're doing like whatever it takes to.
Okay, so what are like problems you have to deal with being a skater?
Constantly like being injured and trying to like get money to buy your like equipment and stuff.
And do you ever have like problems like dealing with like cops or security or anything?
Yeah. Usually like you're on a private property, they'll call the cops. They want to kick you out. It's my passion, and I'll always be skating until I die.
I see your dirty face high behind your collarbone.